Hello and welcome to TechnoCouple channel. If you are from the contact center domain, you certainly have heard about after call work or ACW. Call center agent is responsible for ACW after completing the interaction with the customer and before they accept the next call. After the call is ended, call center agents enter interaction related important information in the agent desktop or CRM application. Traditionally, this data can be anything starting from reason of call, call disposition, call summary, call sentiment, notes, etc. So why is ACW important? ACW can be used for subsequent interactions with that caller or for reporting, agent assist applications, data analysis, dashboards, and for agent training. Agent status is set to not ready for the duration of ACW, which means agents cannot take the next call. Also, completing the ACW needs the agents to take notes during the call while assisting the caller. Agents need to be on their toes to be able to recall all the important details discussed and captured during the call for ACW notes, and this needs to be quick because they are on a clock for ACW. This eventually takes a toll on agents' productivity. If you are from the contact center domain, you know how crucial average handling time for the agent is. AHT is the time taken by the call center agent to handle customer's query on a call, including talk time, hold time, and ACW time. AHT is a key metric for call center and agent efficiency. Now imagine if the agent could solely focus on resolving customer queries than having to memorize the conversation points, taking notes and hurriedly feeding all the data in the CRM application for customer call records. This is possible if ACW can be automated. What's even better is when it is backed by generative AI. In this video, we have automated the process of ACW. This is a minimum viable product and there is no limit to which it can be enhanced to do more. Let's dive into our solution. Almost all call centers have call recording, either full call recording or agent caller recording. More common is to have recording enabled post-transfer, that is conversation between agent and the caller. This recording file is the key element for our solution. This is the basic architecture of ACW automation. We have leveraged Google Cloud Platform for this product. Primary building blocks of ACW automation are Call Recordings GenAI. It's a bucket in GCP's CloudStorage. This is where recordings will get uploaded by the call recording software. The next is ACW with event trigger. It's a serverless backend implemented using GCP's Cloudfunction. This function gets triggered when the file is uploaded in the cloud storage. Next one is the ACW orchestrator. It's a Springboot based REST API hosted on GCP's Cloud Run. Cloud Run is a managed compute platform that lets you run containers directly on top of Google scalable infrastructure. This REST API provides functionalities like audio transcription, call recording analysis for after call work, saving after call work data to a GCP Firestore. And ACW non-structured data storage. This is a GCP Firestore NoSQL document database. It is used to store the after call work data extracted from the call recording. Now let's understand the sequence of events. You can follow the numbers on the screen for clarity. Once the call is completed, the recording is saved in the cloud storage bucket. This triggers our cloud function. Cloud function gets the name of the recently added file, for example interaction1.wave, from cloud storage object. After this, cloud function initiates a REST call of ACW orchestrator hosted on Cloud Run to which the file name is provided. ACW orchestrator downloads this file from cloud storage, transcribes it using OpenAI's Whisper API, and uses the intelligence of GPT with the help of prompt engineering to analyze this recording and find out various parameters like reason of call, sentiment, tags, action items, conversation highlights, agent improvements. We retrieve this data in JSON format for ease of further processing. The above information is stored in GCP Firestore as a document so that this data can be used further for reporting, dashboards, agent assist applications, or for agent training as mentioned before. Since ACW is stored in NoSQL database, we can easily modify the data format as it's in unstructured data. This is the cloud storage bucket where we will upload the audio file for demo. In real life scenario, your call recording software will upload the audio file to this kind of cloud storage. This is the cloud function which will be triggered when the object is finalized that is created in the storage bucket. This is the cloud run console and this is our containerized Spring Boot application hosted on it. This is the container registry which stores images. And finally, this is the Firestore database where we store the ACW data. As of now, we have two documents here. Let's see a quick demo. First, we need to upload the audio file. It's a short conversation between caller and the agent about browser issue. Uploading the file now. Okay, so file is uploaded. And our cloud function is triggered. Let's see. So need to refresh the logs. Okay, yeah, you can see in the logs here, the cloud function was triggered. So as mentioned before, cloud function calls the ACW orchestrator, which will perform transcription and data extraction using OpenAI APIs. Let's check the logs. Okay, yeah, you can see here. Alright, so the processing has finished. So let's check our Firestore. It must have a new document created. So yeah, there you go. You can see the new document with various details like action items, highlights, summary, etc. derived from the call audio. So this automation will greatly help agents to be better at their job as it takes away the burden of mundane tasks off their shoulders so that they can focus on what really matters, the customer service. That's all for now. We will see you in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.